Not much remains of the old O'Cahan stronghold of Dunseverick today. Legend states, though, that at one time the promontory was the summer fortress of Severick, king of ancient Cashel in Tipperary. Severick travelled to the north coast via the Balach Moor, translated as Great Road, constructed all the way from the Irish Midlands, and it linked many of Ireland's centres of powers at that time. Although named around the 3rd century, it had been in existence as a fortification since much earlier times, this due to its natural protection from invaders, surrounded by impenetrable cliffs, jagged rock faces, and a less than hospitable ocean. It is stated in the Tripartite Life, a collection based on the life of St. Patrick, that the saint visited Dunseverick. He's said to have blessed a well, still known as Tubber Patrick, meaning Patrick's Well. In the Book of Armagh, it is stated that Patrick ordained Olcan, whom he'd educated from youth, having baptized the unfortunate child who was found by chance when a passerby heard wailing from a tomb in a nearby townland. Upon opening the tomb, the passerby was amazed to see a baby boy crying by his dead mother's side. Olcan's fortunes changed for the better, and he was later to become a very influential spiritual leader to the Dalriadans, whose center at that time was in nearby Armoy. The kingdom of Dalriada at that time was famed for being a center of learning and refinement, a reputation which Olcan was later to be recognized as a saint for. Remnants of the monastic settlement of Armoy still exist today. One supreme example of craftsmanship from the great monastic period is that of Armoy Round Tower, built around the 8th or 9th century as a defensive retreat for monastic dwellers, still standing proud to this day in church grounds just outside Armoy. Also of note in regard to the rich and varied heritage of Dunseverick is that of a Viking occupation from 871 to 926, a time of great Viking influence along the coasts and waterways of Britain and Ireland. There is a very old story held amongst the O'Cahans which is interesting in this context. Turlach O'Cahan, on his return from the Crusades, found the Danes in occupation of Dunseverick. Their leader had fallen for Turlach's sister, and she had consented to marry him on the condition he be baptized a Christian. The day of the ceremony arrived, and so dissatisfied with the affair was Turlach, that when the abbot of Bangor was about to administer the rite of baptism, Turlach leapt forward and threw Greek fire over the Dane, exclaiming, "You've come here for baptism, I'll baptize you with fire." A fierce struggle ensued between the two mighty warriors, which, like the fire, spread quickly through the castle until many became involved. In the battle, the fort burned, and both antagonists and many more were killed. On witnessing this barbaric and harrowing scene, Turlach's sister could bear no more and threw herself off the cliff's edge into the ocean, where she drowned. It's said that the long, heartbroken wail of old Granuro, the banshee of the O'Cahans, is often heard rising above the winter storm, lamenting the fate of Turlach, his sister, and the fallen members of the O'Cahan clan.